Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon so you never miss a video from Radio 1.
Nushin Al-Qadir is here with me, and these are great times for women's cricket. And it's about time we got a former India bowler, current coach here, to get her opinion on a vista of things. Hi, I hope your family and you are safe and healthy and you've got your vaccines.
Thanks, Vicky. Yes.
You know, you were the second Indian to get 100 ODI wickets after Neetu David. How fresh is the moment in your mind, Nushin? Do you remember the batter you dismissed and everything that went around that particular day?
Absolutely. I think that's something which is special. And it was Lisa Stelekar. It happened in Mumbai. So all fresh memories back in 2012, it happened. So, of course, the best things you always remember. So this has been one of the highlights. It's going to go a long way for me.
Nushin, your only international fifer came in an ODI against England in Lincoln. There were very wet conditions owing to the rain, if I'm not mistaken. How did you manage to bowl with a wet ball and get that success? It's a bit of a mystery to me. It's never easy bowling with a wet ball.
Well, Rishi, I would want to, get back to those memories, because what happened is 2002, since I made the debut, I was not a very consistent player in the 11. And then this particular Lincoln University quadrangular series happened in 2003. And the coach walked up to me saying that you're going to open the bowling. And because it was a run curtailed game, and I remember it was 37 over game. And I wanted to grab the best opportunities which were coming my way. So I didn't leave that opportunity. And back, I would say that I have practiced that way with my coach. So I have kind of bowled with all kind of balls, jahan par seam nahi hoti thi, ball khuli ho jati thi. So, and the reason why he made me do that was I remember him telling me that, you should be able to bowl with any ball. Your grip should be good. So that actually helped me to do it. So wasn't tough for me to do that. And with a new ball, it's always a delight. I don't know. I feel a spinner should bowl with a new ball.
Nice. You've played under the captaincy of Anjum Chopra, Jhulan Goswami, as well as your good friend Mithali Raj. What are the differences in their leadership styles, Nushin?
Jhulan has been an aggressive captain, obviously, because of the kind of nature she has. Anjum and Mithali, I would say that, on the aggressive part, no, they are more calmer. Over a period of time, Mithali was more of a leader for me because of the number of years she's been, was the captain. But I would say that Anjum Chopra, when I got into the team, she was the captain when I made my debut. And when I played my last ODI, she was the captain. So she is a name that I will always remember. That, pehli kaptaan wo meri thi, aur jo maine last game khela tha, wo tabhi bhi kaptaan thi. Of course, yes, I think strategy-wise, they have their own ways of handling and has been successful for India. But I would only compare them with the aggression part. I would stick to that, yes.
It's very beautifully put. India's run in the 2005 Women's World Cup, Nushina. India made the finals for the first time. You must have very glorious memories of that tournament. Talk to me about it.
Oh, yes. It's been, I would say, I would put it across in a very short way. It was a dream. Matlab hai ki humare liye wo abhi bhi khwab hai, jis tarike se humne khela tha wo, jis tarike se humne semi-finals mein we beat New Zealand. Again, us din barish hui thi. I think we do well when it's raining. So, that time, I think 2002, if you remember, New Zealand were the world champions and we beat the world champions in the semi-finals. So that was an achievement. But yes, young side energy was like, I would say 150%. All we knew was we wanted to play the finals. Hame sirf ek hi goal tha, hame finals khelna hai. Because usse pehle India ne kabhi bhi finals nahi khela tha. They would always be there in the semi-finals and lose out. हमने वहां गलती कर दी. आई वी ऑलवेज एज प्लेयर्स टुडे, इवन इफ यू टॉक टू हेमलता काला और अमिता शर्मा और मेलीधर और मिथाली, हमने वही गलती की. हमें ये दुआ करना चाहिए था, हमें फाइनल जीतना था, शायद हम जीत जाते, बिकॉज ऑल आर फोकस वॉज दैट.
You know, it's so wonderful to see players giving back to the game. Anjum's doing such a fabulous job as a broadcaster. You also have such great communication skills. And you continue coaching for the Railways, which is, you know, kind of like your alma mater. So talk to me about, you know, how things are going, you know, how it is being on the park with the girls, working with them.
When I quit, there were options given to me saying that, you know, whether I would want to take up match referee or whether I was interested in taking up selection committee or taking up coaching. And I put my hand up on coaching because it was always a thing that I would want to give back the game, give back to the players. The game has been so dear to us that, there is somewhere we need to be connected. It's very tough for us to just stay away from the game. It's not possible. Dusra, yes, I think over a period of time, I had a good stint with Hyderabad, where I coached them for 5 years. And then I coached a Chhattisgarh team, which has just come in. Unko tab recognition mila tha BCCI mein. So that was a good experience. And now with Indian Railways, who has been winning a lot of games, that's a different experience. So yes, it's been a mixture. But yes, overall, as a coach, it has improved my coaching skills because I've trained different players, different level of players. And it's fabulous to meet different players, their different mentality. It makes you grow like a coach.
Nushin, a lot of different coaching techniques are available today. Do you like to spend a lot of time on video analysis? Or are you more like, let's get onto the park and do it? Some coaches use a very mental approach, have long conversations with the players. What is your approach? Or do you mix and match, you know, horses for courses kind of thing, bits of all these various techniques?
See, I think it's a combination of everything. Okay, talking too much to a player, aajkal ke players itne interested nahi. Unko hai, they want to be on the ground. They want to spend time, they want to feel ki meri batting kaisi ho rahi hai, bowling kaisi ho rahi. Video analysis is something which, as a coach, you need to do it to understand because wo barikiya hame samajh aati hai. But you can't be spending too much of time on video analysis along with the player. It is for you as a coach to do it. And yes, I think let the players be out in the field for them to enjoy because a player ke demand yehi hoti hai ki wo ground pe rahe aur perform kare. This is what a player thinks. I think we need to have an equal balance about everything. Yes, technology is there, but technology can be used in the right way. Should be used only by a coach and not by a player. आपका काम होता है वो समझाने के लिए एक प्लेयर को कि कैसे करना है एंड एज सिंपल एज कम टू द पॉइंट एंड टॉक जितना सिंपल रखोगे उतना रिजल्ट बेटर होगा मेरे हिसाब से.
वेल सेड. वुमेन्स आईपीएल हैज बीन अ हॉट टॉपिक फॉर सम टाइम नाउ इन इंडियन क्रिकेट. नुशीन, सम पीपल आर सेइंग लैक ऑफ डेप्थ एंड दैट्स अ वाइडली साइटेड रीजन फॉर नॉट बिगिनिंग द कॉम्पिटिशन. इज दैट रियली द केस, लैक ऑफ डेप्थ, और डू यू थिंक दैट इज देयर?
I have seen some fabulous players of under 19, 23 and senior because I was lucky enough to coach a lot of under 19s and 23s and seniors. I don't think there's a lack of depth in that. There are some players who don't even get an opportunity to play challengers because the limit is 36 players. So an IPL can give you a platform, at least have 5 to 6 teams. I'm sure India is ready for it. We have players. Where do you get or a Yastika who's coming in and walking in and getting a go in the first game? So we have a lot of players like her around, a player like Richa around. I think IPL would be a very good platform to enhance the game better in India, and it will give opportunities to a lot of players to showcase their games.
The coverage of women's cricket is really improving. There's no doubt about that. Broadcasters have come together. There are websites who are exclusively women's cricket. What are some other measures that can bring the women's game to the forefront in the limelight, Nushin?
I think, like, I would say that, you know, IPL, we have the social media people. There are a lot of other live telecasts and a lot of things taken care of. But I think more games. Unfortunately, we've been hit by the pandemic. But yes, I would see more games before the World Cup. What I've got to know is that we're just playing Australia and then we head to New Zealand, play New Zealand there and play one more series in and we're there. So more games, more game time to the girls would be very good. I would see a lot of games happening. Now I think we're heading for a domestic, which is starting from October. That's going to be good because we're going to see a lot of India players playing that domestic. So that is going to more games. I think we need to have more of days games included now in the scheduling part. So I would it would be lovely to watch 2-day games happening, 3-day games happening at the domestic level, and also for the under-19s as well.
Wonderful to know that you're a consultant on a major Bollywood motion picture called Shabash Mittu, which is on the life and times of Mithali Raj. If I'm not mistaken, Tapsee Pannu is the actress who's involved. Bollywood and Indian cinema has also changed very drastically, and sports films are so realistic these days, Nushin. You must have been quite surprised being on the set. And how was the experience? Because I'm sure it's the first time you're doing something like this.
Oh, fabulous. I think I've been part of Tapsee's training for quite some time. And for her to adapt the game is commendable, because you know what? You know, her profession is just watching and learning, and it's easier for her to handle it. And of course, I've seen her struggle, because there have been times where she has been shooting for another movie and then she comes down for her training, and a good 2-2.5 hours of her training. It's almost like you're training a cricketer. She has been practicing that way. So obviously, she's quite aware of the fact that she is going to be playing a living legend's role. And it's going to be one kind of a movie for Indian cinema, because it's going to be a first movie for on a woman cricketer. So obviously, yes, my shooting set experience, मुझे तो मतलब इतनी idea होती नहीं है कि क्या हो रहा है. The first day I was little zapped कि इतने सारे cameras होते हैं. But yes, I've got used to it. I've seen a lot of cricketers who are working hard on playing this, and it's nice. It's nice to see something different apart from जो आप camera में देखते हो, matches में देखते हो, ये थोड़े लिए मेरे लिए थोड़ा सा अलग होगा.
You know, I'm sure you don't have to work that much with her in the gym, because she's quite fit herself, Tapsee. She's a sports fan. But the drills, are you spending time in the nets with her, getting her to work on Mithali's stance and, you know, the straight drives and the cover drives and things like that?
Yes, yes. I think we have been working on a bit of her fitness as well. We were lucky enough that she had just finished her Rashmi Rocket movie, where she has been portrayed as an athlete. So that has helped us. But yes, Tapsee, over a period of time, I've been doing a lot of sports movie, and it's commendable for her to come into this role. We're actually looking forward, because itna shooting mein hamein pata nahi chalta hai. But yes, she's working very hard on those favorite shots of Mithali. Tough for her, but she's not given up.
Let's come to Australia versus India, the women's first ODI. Mithali Raj scored a superb 61, a fifth successive ODI half century. But somehow the knocks aren't translating to wins for India. What do you think of the batting position? Should she continue batting at 3 or 4? What's your view, Nushin?
See, very easy, but we need to understand there is a management who's taking care of it. There are people involved in understanding the game better, the situation better there. I would love to see her playing at number 3 or 4, because she has been doing that all her career. But we really don't know what the management is looking at. It's, you know, hum idhar baith ke bahut aasani se bol sakte hain, nahin, she should be coming number 3, number 4. But tough to understand. As a cricketer, as a coach or a management, a lot of inputs coming in to understand the situation. I don't see any reason why India not doing well. See, it's a good team. It's a balanced team. We have so much of depth. We saw that in the last game. It's just about converting those runs which we've not scored in the middle order to see us through. Too quick to judge on things. I think we need to give them a little bit of time to settle. Yes.
Alicia Healy and Haynes were involved in a terrific 126-run opening stand. How do you as a bowler dismiss batters when they're in such a mood? Do you have any suggestions for the Indian bowlers?
Tough. I think Healy has been one of the kinds. I think, she means business when she's walking in. We need to have a very good strategy to get her off. And it's important. See, these world-class players, even Lanning yesterday, if you watch, she did give a chance, which went through the slips. So it just does not go with them. It goes with any of us. If you trap a player early in her innings, when she's a bit jittery, because any player walking in has got butterflies in the stomach. So you unko wahi pakadna chahiye. So it is important for us to understand ki hum get their wickets initially, so that it will allow them or allow the Indian team to actually dent the side. Yes, Julen, I think 2017, mein, I cannot forget that ball which she bowled to Meghlani. I think it's one of the balls which is always going to be remaining my favorite, at least, where she got through her defense. So it's something extraordinary we need to do.
The debutants, my God, Yastika Bhatia, I was so impressed by the stylish left-hander. Richa Ghosh, the girl from Siliguri, again impressive. Your thoughts on these girls?
Absolutely. I think we are heading in the right direction. We have good bench, I would say. I'm quite impressed with the way Yastika and even Richa has performed. Fearless. The intent was there. Beautifully, Yastika stepping out, not scared, not freezed in her crease. Similarly, you saw Richa, you know, she tried playing a paddle sweep. She's not worried about it. This is the kind of intent we are looking at the youngsters, and they're actually displaying very good prospect for Indian cricket.
Now, let's move to the second ODI. It's a day-nighter. What would you tell the Indian spinners in terms of adjustments for bowling under the lights, especially considering how they bowled in the first ODI?
I still feel as a bowler, I think we need to be looking more bowling at your stock balls. Too much of variation initially can cause of concern. I would say that, you know, people like Deepti Sharma, Sneha Rana, or for that matter, even Poonam Yadav, who has been bowling, should be more consistent about where the pitching areas are, because that's where allow the batsmen to commit mistakes. And yes, it's not new. I think the girls have practiced in Bangalore in floodlights, so they're quite aware. It's not that ki they're going to be wo directly khel rahe hain. Maine unhe practice karte hue dekha hai floodlights mein. So the preparation is there. So yes, and it's not the first game we're playing under floodlights. So I see us doing well in the second ODI, because thoda time lagta hai hume 14 din ki hard quarantine ke baad ek sirf warm-up game khel ke hum fir, you know, we're judging them too early enough. After a first ODI, I think we need to give them some game time here.
Nushin, do you foresee any changes to India's playing 11 in that second ODI? I know it's management's call, but what does your gut feel say?
I would really want to see Harman coming in, because hame itni news pata chali hai ki she was not available only for her first ODI. Harman coming in, the Australians are always aware that the ex-Harman factor, because the kind of impact she had laid after playing that 171 inning. And Harman, Smriti, these girls have been playing a lot of Big Bash there. So they understand the wickets better. So this kind of, to see her around there, yes. But otherwise, again, it's her call that, you know, how fit she is to play the game. But I see a Raja, Rajeshwari coming in. I would like to see her bowl there, because she has done quite well in the previous game. So yes, a Raja would, a spinner coming in, a left-arm spinner coming in, would definitely help us.
We're only 6 months away from the Women's World Cup. What are areas of concern you think India should address in the ODI series?
I think, again, the middle order. This middle order has been a concern for us, because unki consistency nahi rahi hai. You know, sometimes we're too dependent on the top order and the and them performing. पर हमें ये भी तो समझना चाहिए कि हमारे मिडिल ऑर्डर इतना कंट्रीब्यूट कर रहा है नहीं कर रहा है ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम इट हैज बीन अ कंसर्न एंड आल्सो आवर बोलिंग आई डोंट थिंक वी हैव इन द राइट इंटेंट और अ प्लान टू बोल टू बिकॉज़ आई फील दैट द बोलर्स आर बोलिंग बोथ साइड्स द कंसिस्टेंसी इज लैकिंग सो वी नीड टू करेक्ट दैट एरिया एंड एज यू नो दिस नीड्स टू बी करेक्टेड एज सून एज पॉसिबल 6 months इज अ लॉट वी कैन डू दैट. So these two areas, I think overall our fielding has been good, but because of our bowling being on both sides, our fielding looks a little, concerned. But yeah, it's the other way around. Hamari bowling achhi honi chahiye, because you're not bowling to the fielders. So yes.
This unbeaten streak is worrying all Indian fans. 25 matches, Australia, a record winning streak in ODIs. Do you see this Indian team ending that streak? And how can that run really be stopped?
I think only Indians can do that. Hamare andar wo kabiliyat hai ki hum ye kar sakte hain. So yes, Aussies, I think we should be congratulating them, because it's a big feat. But yes, wo log us tarike ka cricket khel rahe hain. I understand that, you know, it is a concern. Yaar, Australia bahut acha cricket khelti hai, but hame ye bhi samajhna chahiye ki wo bahut badhiya cricket khelte hain. They are prepared for any situation. You see them coming in, they know what they're doing. and only Indian team can beat that. And
lovely. Listen, the first ever day-night test match is set to be played. Now, Australia have already played one day-night test match. I understand that, you know, the girls have played under the lights in Bangalore. You know, there is a day-night, you know, ODI encounter that we were talking about. But tests are a different cup of tea or a kettle of fish. You can't say, I will play it as five ODIs and, you know, it makes a test match. So how do you think the Indian unit will fare? How do you think one can prepare for something as unknown as a 5-day or a test match, which is day and night?
See, a ping ball test game is going to be challenging, just not for the Indians, but also the Australians. They have an upper hand because they're playing at the home conditions. Okay. As far as I feel the test is concerned, the last we played was in 2006 against Australia, and they were very good then. Not that this Australian side is not good. But at the same time, you know, it is going to be a good contest. Okay. Because test allows you to display your potential. It shows how good you are in your temperament. It gives you time to settle. And we have the kind of players. We have a Smriti. We have a Shefali. You know, there are different kinds. Then we have a Poonam Raut who's coming in, who's very technically sound. We see a Mithali Raj who's done well in the test games. Julen, of course, is outstanding. So yes, it is going to be challenging. It's not going to be easy, but for both the teams, just not going to be for India. The only advantage what the Aussies have is the home conditions.
History is with us, Nushin, as far as T20Is are concerned. The last time India played a bilateral T20I series in Australia against Australia, that was 2016. We had returned victorious. You think we're going to repeat that in the T20Is?
I see that happening in the one days also. You know, I wouldn't say India kheli hu to chahungi yaar India jeete. So India 100% we're going to win.
Lovely.
Tough, let me tell you, it's tough. It's not easy. Baat karna bahut aasan hota hai par ladkiyan wahan mehnat kar rahi hai, to us mehnat ki wajah se main yahi chahungi ki India acha kare.
My last question is about Mithali Raj. What to you is the biggest quality, her biggest strength as a player and a human being?
Her calmness. She's calm and composed, or she knows what she's doing. That's important. And she knows what she wants to do.
What she wants to do. Wonderful. The second ODI of India Tour of Australia Women happens on the 24th of September, 10:40 a.m. And third ODI, 26th of September at 5:35 a.m. live on Sony 6 channels. And thank you very, very much, Nushin Al-Khadir, for speaking to us. And all the best in all your endeavors. And let's keep cheering for India. And thank you for your services to the nation. Cheers.
Thank you, Rishi. Take care.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon so you never miss a video from Radio 1.